like a mule. It has some strengths that my YZ250X doesn't have. The YZ250X is the stallion, you know. It's light. It's got the suspension. You can hit jumps, you can go fast. This bike, it still goes pretty darn fast. I was surprised. It goes about 120 kilometers an hour stock. And it's got the low-end power. Better gearing, honestly. You can go up the, you know, rocky, rooted hill climbs that would, you know, stall the YZ250X if you had it anywhere below half throttle going up that. But with this bike, it can really tractor up that stuff. If you're doing hard enduro, yeah, I can see that. But I mean, it's pretty obvious. This bike isn't made for hardcore riding. It can do it, yes, if you're good enough. But it is not made for flat diamond trails. Also, I noticed in the sand, or when the gravel's really loose, that works against this bike because of its weight. So, I mean, I don't do much of that riding, so it doesn't really matter. This trail in spring with the YZ, but there was fallen logs all over it, so I'm sure it would be clear by now, so we're gonna find out. No, I'm in the groove of this bike. It didn't take too long to get in the groove. Bike feels good. trail today. I wonder if they were helping break it in. Cutting down some brush or something. Going downhill with this bike thanks to the engine brakes. You know, you forget how heavy this bike is. 282 pounds, which is pretty dang heavy. We're going that way. That's when you remember it. Is when the bike almost tips over, or if you're trying to lift it. It's actually not, you know, the seat height isn't actually low. It's about the same as my YZ. On paper, looks lower. Maybe it is a smidge lower, but not enough to really feel the difference. In the groove, no, that's not gonna matter. Where does it go? There it is. We're taking the fresh one. She can make it over going uphill. Looks like the other guy struggled with it. Ho ho! Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Serious traction, baby. Here.